Hi, today I'm in this beautiful area of lush pasture. We have the sheep in the field, we have the beautiful crop fields with the wheat and the barley. So different shades of colours in the landscape. This is called Brixton Deverill. I did an art demonstration a while back with the poppy field. I'm afraid the poppy field is gone now. But we have beautiful shades of yellows and golds. So I'm going to demonstrate to you this beautiful cobalt blue sky, these lovely cloud formations, and just subtle areas where the landscape basically flows down into a dip. So just gentle fencing and a few bushes and trees. So I'm going to be using a wolf hair Chinese brush. I absolutely love these type of brushes. They've been quite new to me over the past year. So I invested in buying one of these, pure wolf hair. And then the paints I'm going to use are Holborn. Okay, so you can buy Holborn on most art sites, particularly Amazon is really good. If you want some really nice watercolours, I definitely recommend Holborn. So I'm going to use crimson, cobalt blue and gamboge. They're my favourite colours at the moment. Too windy today, so I can actually just hold this paper. I'm going to demonstrate a wet and wet loose technique. So my first wash is going to be getting this warmth of colour on to just warm up that paper. So obviously always remember to just wet the paper and then apply the colour. And then this is areas where the paper is dry, and so you've got, this is where I leave my little slits of light. Okay, so I've ditched my easel because all of a sudden the wind's picked up, and they did say it was going to be showery and windy today on and off. So I really have to work quick. When you're working outside, it's a great way of just releasing the paint onto the paper. It's a great feeling. So I'm just going to get these lovely shades on now. I'm not going to try too hard and make it too perfect because it's just an idea. Okay, so when you look at the landscape, don't worry about how perfect it's got to be. I'm applying the blue, the little bits of blue that are appearing in the sky, the energy. Scrub with your brush, dab and dash with your brush. Get excited about what you're doing. The brush, create that liveliness, because it doesn't have to be perfect, but you've got to get that atmosphericness. Now just above these wheat fields, this dark consuming stormy sky looming above. So here we go, we're going to try and sort of get it more sort of subdued. Just above that horizon, almost, above that hill line. Almost let the colour just absorb down into that field. Okay. Okay, so I'm mixing. When I do paint, I always paint like this. I mix quite furiously and just to get that excitement on the paper. And then always have some light coming into it as well at the same time. Let that cascade down. So tip the paper, let that come down, just let it come down and then bring it across. Don't worry about it overlapping into the other colours, because that's natural, then it's not set. So I'm going to just let that come down now. So what I want to do now is just do a little bit of a grouping of some trees. I just love this little air of trees to the side. And then there's a curvature of the field coming round. So that's, to me, I love that bit. I'm just going to swirl my brush, sweep it. They're just blobby and soft. Okay, so just drop those colours. Here we go again, the wind is picking up again. This is the hardest thing about painting outside. You're always constantly up against it with our English climate. Going on, and you know, so there's lots of different distractions, but don't worry about that when you're painting outside. Just go with it. That is the best advice I can actually give you. Just go with it. Okay, so just don't worry when you're doing wet on wet, if all the colours, you know, the shapes that you're trying to create with your brush just disappear, because I'll show you how you can bring them out again as it starts drying. I'm trying to create a darker tone of the different shades again over this field. I'm just going to sweep my brush over that bit, and then obviously put a bushy tree there, maybe another one going out. I'm just trying to get the idea of it again. Changing. The sky is constantly changing when you paint outside, but I always paint either from my imagination or outside from reality. I don't like using photographs at all. another thing I was going to say is if you get a hair on your paper, don't let that distract you too much from what you're doing. You can always pick out that hair when it starts to dry. I think when I'm teaching, the most annoying thing for my students is always hairs that fall out of the brushes. But, you know, you don't want to worry about things like that. It really doesn't matter. Again, just scrub and scribble with your brush for the shapes. Okay, they do not have to be perfect. What is perfection? You know, it's all about being expressive. I'm just going to finish off down here and bring in, you know, just a few interesting kind of fence posts maybe, or I don't know, something like that. Watercolour wash as it's drying, yes, you get this kind of marking. So what I use is a filbert brush. They're absolutely amazing. They've got a very long stem, and when you buy them, it's hog's hair, so it's pure white. So obviously I've used this for a long time and it's gone that sort of colour now, but it's hog's hair, okay? So you can use it for acrylic or oil or watercolour. But it's really good for just removing awkward little markings, and it's disappeared. Look at that. Okay, I'm just gonna just slightly go over that as well. It's just to tidy up a bit. Okay. And now we are done. Hi. So now I've completed my Wet in Wet watercolour. Again, the conditions were not easy. The wind picked up at one point, so I decided to forget about the easel and lay it flat on the back of the lid of the boot, and it was a lot easier then to control. So that's really important. You have to be in control with watercolour, but also you want to be expressive and loose to create the energy. So the inspiring bit was the colours, particularly, and the sky today in this beautiful area of Longbridge Deverill in Wiltshire. Bye for now.